So, you want me to believe that you voted for a racist, rapist, convicted felon, business fraud who incited a deadly attack on our capital after losing the last election because of the price of eggs? That you voted for the orange dip dude who ran with a different VP because the last one was nearly hanged for not breaking democracy because you've been getting fewer hours at your job these days? You want me to believe that you voted for someone who nearly every economist in the world has said will grow our debt, which he did by the third largest amount ever the last time, increase our costs, raise inflation, and destroy our GDP because a burger and fries is more expensive than it used to be? You want me to believe that you voted for the drink bleach guy who golfed while thousands of Americans were dying a day because you had it so much better then, when you were stockpiling toilet paper, than you do now? You want me to believe that you voted for the guy who had 4 years to pass an infrastructure bill and didn't, the guy who said Mexico would pay for the wall when they didn't, the guy who promised to bring manufacturing back, lower the cost of prescription drugs, and end the opioid crisis but didn't because you preferred his policies? You want me to believe that you voted for the grab-him-by-the-pussy guy who wants to destroy the Department of Education and to repeal the ACA despite the fact that he has nothing more than concepts of a plan to replace it? The guy who will roll back environmental protection, strip women and minorities of more rights, the guy who will hand Ukraine to Putin and Gaza to Netanyahu, the guy who has said he will be a dictator on day one because you're worried about losing your gas stove? I'm sorry, but I don't believe any of that. And frankly, I'm not sure you believe it either. Because the truth is that your vote wasn't about any of that. You voted for the traitorous embodiment of the seven deadly sins because when it came to casting your ballot for a black woman, you just couldn't do it. And because you like getting away with being your worst self. And because life is a whole lot easier to stomach when all that has gone wrong for you is someone else's fault. Let's be honest. That is what it was. So, when the price of eggs is $18 and your Latino neighbors have been deported or moved to some effed up camp to pick the strawberries none of you will pick, and your miscarrying wife has to contend with sepsis before she's allowed to have an abortion, and your autistic child is unable to get the early intervention they desperately need, please remember what it really was that you voted for. Because I promise you, the rest of us, we'll never, ever forget.